Good morning, beloved. And welcome to prayer and meditation. I'm so grateful to have you here this morning. And even grateful for technical difficulties at the beginning of a program. It humbles us, you see. It allows us to recognize we are human, and that there's nothing wrong with a mistake or two. And so I allow myself this morning to forgive others and myself. Critical components to the mystery of walking in the Spirit. Please find a comfortable position and know that anytime throughout prayer and meditation, whatever works for you, beloved, is what is important here. In a deep breath through your nose and exhale through your mouth. Take in another deep breath through your nose and exhale through your mouth. That very simple breathing technique is how I overcome the trips of my monkey mind. It pulls everything back into perspective. And I invite you throughout the day to gently remind you, no matter what you're dealing with on the highest mountain or lowest valley, all you need to do, find a comfortable position, take a deep breath through your nose, and exhale through your mouth. It is the equivalent of when the prophet stood on the boat and spoke to the waves and said, "Peace, be still." There was calm on the water. Whatever we may be dealing with this morning in this prayer room, be it one of the four quadrants, financial, peers, our environment, or our purpose. My prayer for you and I this morning is this, or something better, is waiting for you and I. The sacred text for this morning is from the book of Numbers, chapter 6, verses 21 through 26. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. I'm grateful that we in modern times recognize that scripture has nothing to do with feudal lord systems or a gender, but that God shines upon us. And God gives us peace. I have some victories to share after our silent meditation. For I believe we must give testimony to the power of prayer and meditation. And so, beloved, as we're about to step off into the silence, I invite you to prepare your prayer intentions and receive the voice of God. As we both step off and journey together in this circle, in the silence. Welcome back. Wasn't that lovely to just sit and listen to the silence? Giving in to anger, fear, and suspicion disturbs our minds and our well-being, whereas trust and friendship are the basis of society. The Dalai Lama. My prayer for you, beloved, this morning. If there is fear, that it would dissolve like a transition in a movie into something beautiful, protective, and empowering. My prayer for you this morning. If finances trouble you, that you would receive double in blessing. My prayer for you this morning, if you are having troubles with a friend, a loved one, a peer, the Spirit would provide a way for healing. My prayer for you this morning, if you're kind of wondering what your purpose is, that the scales would fall from your eyes and you would see clearly, as though as if the rain had just cleared and the sun opened up the sky. As many know, I have been bitten off a little more than I could chew to try to get set back up with the technical gear that I needed. A few have stepped up and helped me in mighty ways, and I am so grateful to my friends and family that have done so. Those that couldn't have prayed, and that equals just as much power. This week, I received sponsorship for a gym membership to the Princeton Club. I also received the financial blessing to be able to purchase renter's insurance. But the most beautiful gift of all, out of nowhere, a dear friend at Madison Mutual Aid Network signed a contract with me for one of my credit cards. It is completely paid off. I have to pay the money back, but the beautiful thing is, it is interest-free. This is the power of prayer, beloved. In the last couple of weeks, I've been pretty much bedridden in pain. Tuesday morning, I had enough and picked up the phone and called chiropractors in town. Several did not answer, but the third one that answered accepted my insurance and got me in the hour. I went from a pain level of 9.5 on Monday to around a 5 today. I share these things to celebrate the power of prayer, beloved. And I thank you. And my intention now, I've been offered a bigger apartment in the same building with a bathtub so that I can soak my sore body. And it's a two-bedroom unit, so my studio would be in one, and I would actually have a living room. This or something better is waiting for you and I. Go in peace, beloved, and as always, namaste.